speed. However, if I try to do that when they're not around, because at least one of them needs to be able to push me, then I will get a kick instead, and that kick also gives me a little bit of speed. Of course, there's flight, very useful for cross gaps and, you know, climbing stuff. A lot of good stuff. Other than that, there's also some interactables around, like this bobsled right here. Each of the formations represents a part of the bobsled. Knuckles does the steering, Tails does the jumping, Sonic does the, well, going fast, I suppose. Rub up against that wall a bit to get some extra height. And every time you'll see me pass through those boosters in the air right there, I'll also use Tails' attack, which is called Thundershoot. And that will actually reset my flight. Normally, after hitting one of those boosters, you cannot fly, but if I do a Thundershoot, then I get my flight back and I also fall to the ground faster. Oh, first man was frozen screen. Oh well. Shit happens. You could just use your imagination for all of that. All of what I said still applies anyway. So one of the other interactables you saw was the cannon right there. Depending on what formation you're in, it will shoot you at two different places. Gonna skip this loop right here. And right at the end of the stage, there is a little shortcut that is not really intended. You're supposed to drop down from the top to get a 1-up. But with enough speed from the loop and a nice jump, you can just skip the rest of the stage and go directly up to the goal ring. Yes. Easy peasy. Pretty nice seaside hill.
Shoot. Not my day.
So thank you for the good luck, Uru. I will need it at some point. Especially if this game is in a mood, which it might be. We will see. Anyway, here we have Ocean Palace. Right here at the start, my teammates somehow have the most amount of trouble to actually stay behind me and give me rocket exhales. Being a Ganesh dev. But yeah, here Knuckles finally gets some nice use. Break all of the stuff. I guess I broke some stuff in CZU as well. Knuckles is also supposed to glide using those gigantic fans right there. But in that case, I could just use flight formation. Also, wow, Knuckles is now a pancake. Again, use the environments to get a little bit of extra height, and here we have a little nice trick known as a mid-air kick, where I will use a rocket accelerator to build up speed, and then gets towards... As soon as I get towards the edge of the platform, I do a kick, which will let the game think that I am on the ground for the remainder of the animation, so I can jump out of it. In the meantime, though, we have our new trick. And our next trick with this little robot right here. There we go. That is called a bop boost. And it is one of the most jankest abilities that we are somehow able to use consistently in this run. The way it works is I hit the enemy in a way where that Sonic gets knocked out of the flight formation. Right at the same time that Knuckles touches the ground. And this makes the game think that the flight formation is complete, even though Sonic is stuck on the ground because he's stunned for a fixed amount of time. And if I were to start a flight in that formation, I will get pulled towards where Sonic is at an insane speed, because in flight formation, when flying, Knuckles tries to grab onto Sonic. So he continues to try to do that. And will get pulled towards where Sonic is, since Sonic himself cannot move. However, if I put a wall in between where Sonic is stunned on the floor and where Tails is, since I'm still controlling him, I will get all of that speed in the opposite direction of the wall. It makes no sense why it does that. But it's nice that it does. Allows me to skip a whole bunch of sections in the game. Is this run fastest on GameCube? Doesn't really matter that much between GameCube and Xbox. Technically it's fastest on PC, but PC is a different build and is actually a very, very different run, so it's a separate category. It's also way less fun than to do, in my opinion, so I tend to run the console version. In the meantime, we have arrived at our first boss, right here. We need to chase him down to a beach. Or in this case, I'm just gonna pull him to the beach that is right behind me, because that saves time. And on my way here, I picked up an invisibility power-up in that crate. Which will mean my teammates will not get bodied by the attacks I do on Eggman right here. Easy boss fight. Anyway, now we go on to the next area, city area, Grammetropolis. And right at the start we have a little nice speed trick, because Sonic has an ability called Light Dash where he just dashes along a trail of wings. And if I switch to power formation during it, I get all of the speed that I have during Light Dash, and it will be transferred over to Knuckles. And then by switching back to Sonic, I can switch back to Sonic, transfer it back to Sonic. It's pretty nice like that. I can also carry it over into a glide. I actually did that earlier in Ocean Palace, but that place was already full of tricks. Can only explain so much. This is also the first stage where level-ups become a factor. In the top right you have the formations, and each of them has like three little white dots that can be filled up. And those represent the level-ups, and they do various things. In this case, for Sonic, the level-ups do... On 1 and 2, it gives his homing attack more damage. And the interesting stuff comes in at number 3. However, first I have a door to click through. The doors are suggestions, mainly. But yeah, at level 3, Sonic will get wind physics on his homing attack. And that will allow me to latch onto poles and de-shield enemies with my homing attack. It's very useful. Here we also have another bot boost. Alright, there. Cancelled it with a thunder shoot. That's a nice thing. And then here, use the homing attack to latch onto the pole. It's a bunch faster. There are also other things that have wind physics, like the Rocket Excel that I've been doing, or the main method that the game intends you to use for wind physics, the Blue Tornado attack. But that one has a really long animation, so I try to avoid using it. Use another mid-air kick to cross that gap. Of course, if I try to jump out of that kick too late and the animation is already over, the game will realize, hey, you're not on the ground anymore, and it will not let me jump, so... Gotta be careful about that. It's all about the balance of getting the most amount of distance versus actually not falling to your death. Next up, we have Power Plant. This is a pretty difficult stage, I'm not gonna lie. There's a lot of really tough movements, some jumps from ramps and stuff that are quite tricky to get. But yeah, we're gonna see what we can make happen. I'll also be collecting level ups for Tails. And what level of Super Flight Formation is, it alters his Thundershoot attack, which is normally used to stun enemies. At level 1, oh my god, my phone is going off, I should probably mute that when I get the chance. At level 1, the Thundershoot will also bounce to nearby enemies, and Sonic will, and Knuckles will no longer get stunned in the process. So that's a pretty nice one. Also here we have a little fly trick. If I use the Flight XL, Tails' Wii ability, so I like to call it, right as I hit the ground, then I will get the height from the Flight XL. While also resetting my flight and being able to get higher. In the meantime, we have also achieved level 2 Tails. And at level 2, the Thundershoot will do damage. And it will one-shot all of these basic enemies. And the reason I want that is the upcoming elevator. Because it's at several points, or in this elevator's case, only one point. It will stop in order, because there's a barricade and I have to defeat enemies to destroy the barricade. But with level 2 Tails, I could just do that before I even stand still. Should probably also explain where I'm getting these level ups from to begin with, and there's three ways to get them. The first way is checkpoints, where I will get a level up. Oh my goodness! I will have to save myself here. Welp! I got a little bit too close to the edge there. That was my own downfall. Ah, that's a shame. Now I've lost my level ups. But yeah, as I was saying, where you get level ups from. One method is from checkpoints, where you get a level up for whatever formation you're in. There's also fixed drops that are throughout the stage that I can pick up. That's how I got my first level up in the stage. And now I have to sit through the lovely elevator again. Without my level ups this time, so... Whoop-de-doo! Good job, me. You done good. Stay away from the edge this time. And then the third way is to get level ups is by defeating 5 enemies. And when after the fire, the 5th enemy will drop a level up that is for either of the 2 formations that you are not in. So you have a 50-50 chance. If I destroy something with Knuckles, I will get either a level up for Sonic or for Tails. In this case for Tails, which is nice because I do need level 2 on him for the second elevator. An unfortunate mistake, but we're back to where we want to be. Try to get a nice ramp jump here. Jumped a little bit too early. So I get height, but not distance. This is the more important one, and I get this one. Nice. Yeah. Want to give me a light dash there? The Trail of Rings is a bit of a pain in the ass. So yeah, this is probably a good time to start talking about Knuckles' glide ability, which is pretty dang useful for carrying momentum. it preserves a lot of it before it actually, you know, goes back to the normal speed it's supposed to go at. Dude, thank you. That means I'm just gonna dick around. Just gotta wait for the elevator, really. Try to get a flight excel jump right at the end there. Get some more height, but didn't get it. Timing for it is a bit different than usual because the elevator is moving upwards. Now we have a section that a lot of the people that played this as a kid really dreaded. The lava chasing you down. Little did they know, all you need is flight formation and, well, to not panic. Do not entry into panic. Of course, having level details to instantly destroy the robots is also rather useful. So yeah, an unfortunate power plant, but stuff happens. Sure, good. Hopefully the rest of the run should be fine. Next up we have the boss fight for this area, which is a battle against a different team, in this case Team Rose. And all of their actions are based on my actions, so in theory they can be pretty well manipulated, but in practice it can be quite a bit harder. Other teams though do have ways to manipulate the enemy into jumping up the stage. In this case though we are just gonna do some thunder shoots. And there we go. Didn't even have to move. Knocked the first two off with the initial salvo, and then I manipulated Amy into jumping so that I could knock her out of the air and off the stage. Anyway, next up we have Casino Sages, and these are the fun ones. Here's stuff where stuff is gonna go crazy. Cause switching formations on pinball tables allows for some pretty fun stuff. Normally, whenever you switch formations, you just stay in the same place and that team member will go to wherever you are. When you're on a pinball table, however, you go to wherever that teammate is. It doesn't matter if he's on his way to falling to his death, you will end up where they are. And we're gonna abuse that in combination with Knuckles' Punch, which calls back teammates forcefully at a pretty insane speed. So, drop them pretty far down, because the lower they are, the higher the speed at which they travel back at from the punch. And then we jump onto the table, and switch formations, flight, because Tails, shut up, way past Knuckles. And from there, we can just end up where Tails is at and skip part of the stage. We also have another bop boost here. This one goes really fast because of how far away from the wall Sonic is. So I have to cancel it really quickly. And that was a really nice one. Then we're gonna do another one of those pinball table launches. There we go. A lot of height on that one. And then we do actually have to be on the pinball table for a bit, but not for long, luckily. There we go, and we just kind of clip underneath those lasers. Fortunately, my teammates got bodied in the process, so I had to wait till they recovered. And for the end, we just fall down onto the goring. There we go. Has anyone ever done like a 100% run of this game? I have, actually. It's currently 9 hours and 45 minutes, I want to say, if I remember correctly. I don't know, I've only done one run since I've routed it, because, you know, it's stupid long. There's so much to do. It gets all of the A-ranks. Which, it's pretty much all there is to do, except super hard mode, which doesn't really track. It's kind of like the completionist bonus. In the meantime, here is Bingo Highway. That door is not real, it is merely an hallucination.
Leave them to me, Sonic.
So if you remember the pinball table launching trick, and I hope you do because it was in a previous stage, we're gonna take it a bit further. Gotta drop them off again, but this time I'm gonna wait the full 3 seconds for them to respawn. Except on the place where Tails is supposed to respawn, I made sure there was no solid ground. And because of that, Tails gets stored outside of draw distance until he has a place to actually respawn. And while I'm on the pinball table, he cannot respawn either, so he's still waiting there. Now I'm just gonna bounce into spring for like 30 seconds, and every time I hit the spring, Knuckles' movement gets locked, so I can hold whatever direction without Knuckles moving, which allows me to manipulate Tails' position into a position where I want him to be. I'm gonna jump back on the ledge, do a little bit more manipulation, jump back on the table, switch so that I end up where Tails is at, and I'm gonna go towards the end of the stage. And this is just gonna take a while. Mm-hmm. Very pretty background though. Very pretty background. I'm actually pretty dang happy to skip exists because this level is an absolute pain in the ass to do normally. And there we go. There is the end right there. Gonna go right to the goal ring.
Right.
Easy peasy. Also, I was gonna put my phone on mute. Cause I... There we go. People were like texting me and stuff. Ugh. You thought Heroes wasn't that glitchy. Oh, you're silly. This game has the biggest variety of glitches in the universe.
Eggman.
Unfortunately, I didn't get the one that glitches out that cutscene, but I get another chance at that at Robot Slug. But yeah, casually, it's like nowhere near as glitchy as, say, Sonic 06 or Boom. It's a much better casual play, but if you actually, you know, look for stuff and realize all the stuff that's going on, yeah, it actually has a huge variety of glitches. Anyway, this boss fight is just waves of robots, and it's pretty much how fast I can go kind of depends on how lucky I get with the level ups, and I got really lucky because I got level 2 Tails right off the bat. Remember, the level ups you get from enemies are 50-50. There we go. Now, in the meantime, we haven't talked about Knuckles' level ups yet, because, well, they haven't been relevant up until now. But what he does is, for every level up, he gets a different finisher at his combo. And from level 2 onwards, he can just basically place a nuke on the ground. Oh, didn't get the robot. Just have to take him out of level 3 Sonic. But yeah, he can basically just drop an attack on the ground, and it has an insane radius. And it'll last for a little while. He's an absolute powerhouse in these robot wave boss fights. And I actually go out of my way to get him in some stages as well. From level 2 onwards, he's just insane. I love it. Fortunately, my execution wasn't really as good as I would like it, but it was just fine.
What a waste. Mm-hmm.
Next up, we have Rail Canyon, and rails are probably pretty infamous in this game because they don't really work that well. It's like at least you won't fall through them very quickly, but if you try to switch rails, then you will very likely either not hit the rail you were going for or not hit a different rail at all and just fall to your death. You kind of got to know where it is safe to switch rails. Fortunately, I know those things. Skip the first set of rails right here by falling down. And now we also have a bot boost. Another one, yeah. And for this one, I actually need to make sure I get the right amount of distance on it. Oh boy. That wasn't gonna end well. So, how far you get with your bot boost is determined by two things. The first of it, one is the duration. And the duration is always fixed. Like Sonic, after I think 3 seconds it is, will recover and your bot boost will end. So in order to get the most out of it, you want to make it to whatever wall you're bot boosting off of as soon as possible. And in order to do that, there's actually a little trick where you can start a flight and then do a flight excel. You will get pulled back to Sonic, but you can carry that speed into your movements by holding a direction. And that will actually get you to the wall path much faster. So I used that right there. The other factor is the amount of speed you get. And the amount of speed you get is based on the distance between Tails and Sonic when you do the boosting part of the glitch. So yeah, you also gotta make sure where Sonic lands whenever you do these bot boosts. Up until now, it hasn't really been that big of an issue. In Ocean Palace, I had a wall that would catch me. And in Casino Park and in Grand Metropolis, I would just cancel it early to make sure I didn't like overshoot or cliff through something. But yeah, here, you gotta really calculate your distance. Something I've also been doing is switching between power formation and speed formation whenever I am on the rails. This doesn't actually make you go any faster, but it will get you to your max speed faster. So in this game, you can hold the action button to grind. And whenever you first start grinding, you get a little bit of an initial boost. And that initial boost can be triggered multiple times in a row. By switching between
getting creepy around here. It's because we're getting closer to the center. I guess we're heading in the right direction.
In the meantime, we have Bullet Station.
Got it.
And Bullet Station is a cycle-based stage. From the moment I started the stage, there a bunch of giant cannons started doing their cycles, and I am totally missing the optimal cycle right now because of that nonsense. But yeah, every 3 seconds they will shoot, and how fast you can do this stage depends entirely on those cycles, because there's also one right before the glow ring. Sure I don't get bodied by that spike ball. All of this nonsense right here. Just jumping up the rails. It's easy. Here we do another midair kick to skip one of the poles, and that saved exactly 0 seconds, but it looks cool, so whatever it's worth. Use my wind physics to activate all 3 switches at once. Easy peasy. And here I use Fire Formation, specifically the Inlet Cannon, to bust open the door. Ah, didn't even make that one. So yeah, I'm like 4 cycles off where I want to be. Yeah, it was a pretty bad opening. So that lost me like a good 12 seconds. As long as I do the rest of this properly though, I can still make the fastest cycle from here on the final cannon. Your time gain and time loss is entirely determined by cycles in this stage. Which ones do you get? Sit stream at this hour indeed, I guess. Earthbound Runner didn't show, so we had to get some runs to replace it. I figured, hey, why not do a late night Sonic Heroes run for these guys? It's, why not? And then I go to sleep and then I wake up and then I almost instantly, well, give or take a few hours, do another run. The one that's actually scheduled. Whoop. Alright, I think I lost the cycle on that one as well. I'm not entirely sure. Streamer, you didn't even get an A rank. Though I'm pretty sure I am supposed to get an A rank on that one from time bonus alone, but I messed around too much. Most stages though, it's you don't get enough from the time bonus, since ranks are score based. But hey, luckily they're irrelevant to the run. So here is the first boss, but this time with a Zeppelin and a cannon attached that I have to get rid of as well. Once again, I am not actually doing the intended way in chasing him down, I'm just gonna keep him on the initial platform. Keep calling him back. As long as I don't hold the control stick and just keep mashing B, then Knuckles will keep punching and punching. And bam. The actual egg hog part is much weaker, luckily, so I can one-shot that nonsense. Thank you for the good luck sandwich. I do still have one luck-based thing coming up. It's the second boss fight. With waves of robots. Robot Storm. It's after the spooky sages. First though, we have Frog Forest, and this one is, well, you'll see how busted it is. It's very open, and the walls are slanted very slightly upwards, so you can get both distance and height off of bot boosts, and yeah, then you'll see what that does to the actual run. I am not sure that was enough distance, so I'm gonna play it safe. Let's go! Let's go! Oh my goodness, that's a lot of distance. I hope I didn't overshoot. And I should be fine. Cool. Yeah, I'm A-okay. Maybe to get it, maybe I'll make up for missing both cutscene glitches. I've missed the first one again, so I get one more chance. So yeah, let's skip the majority of the stage, and I'm gonna skip the last half by using these speed shoes to do what is called the triple titty climb! There we go. It is way too late to be shouting like that. So yeah, you get a lot of speed from those loops, and you also get a lot of speed in the air because of those speed shoes. Funnily enough, the speed shoes give basically nothing but acceleration, like no extra speed or anything on the ground. But in the air, it makes you go way faster. I'm not sure what's up with that, but it does allow for that wonderful glide. Man, people are probably not happy with me yelling like that.
You sure it's safe around here?
Leave it to me. Let's go. Let's go.
The rain, the black frog,
Lost Jungle time. So in this stage, I am going to get level 2 Knuckles from the checkpoints. Because, well, you've seen what a powerhouse Knuckles is. I need to take care of some robots for me. This stage is also pretty nicely designed. There's a lot of small skips possible. It's just very fun to do. And these loops, well, why bother with them? Just jump straight down. That's easy. And you can rub up against that wall a bit to get some extra height. And this is the robots that I needed Knuckles for. Just drop that combo and they are history. See, even the big ass hammer robots are not a problem. Not until they start wearing helmets, at least. At that point, they also get armor for the rest of their body and they become just too damn slow. But we won't see those until Mystic Mansion. Alright, laser clip right here. Nice! I got the fast one. Whether you get a good time here is entirely determined by that pretty inconsistent laser clip. There is a 100% consistent way to clip through it, but that setup takes, you know, forever. And you kinda gotta get rid of the robots to do it properly as well, so yeah. But it's a good backup at least. Yeah, the rest of the stage ain't too bad, it's just a laser clip. So here's this alligator. Really, as long as you just pay attention to how to find swing, you're A-okay. The game tries to bait you into going in a rhythm by spacing them out seemingly... you know, at similar distances, but then at various points it throws it up, so if you actually try to follow a rhythm, you will most likely end up pressing it too early. Or jumping up too early at one point and, you know, dying. Dying's not good. Dying's bad. Do not enter into dying. The boss for this zone is another team battle, this time with Team Dark. And the strat is pretty much the same, except it probably won't be as fast. Yeah, don't even have to move. I need to change the camera a bit. There we go. Thundershoot to win. Many runners, myself included, when I first ran this, make the mistake of, you know, actually moving forward a bit during that boss fight. You just don't even touch your controls like at all. Just switch to flight and start spamming Thundershoots. Playing this on PS2 is awful with everything, Cooper Crisp. It does not run properly.
Sonic, you sure this is the right way?
I saw Shadow and Eggman head this way. This has gotta be the right way.
But it's so spooky here!
Maybe that's the ghost of Shadow we saw earlier.
Ooh. Stop it, Knuckles!
Spooky. So to celebrate the upcoming Halloween, here's two spooky stages, even as pumpkins. Very scary pumpkins, I hope y'all don't get spooked. Trigger warning, spooks. And alongside Frog Forest, this is the stage that gets broken the most by Bot Boost. As well as other things, because before we even get there, we have a door skip right here. To skip having to go down here and do a whole other section. And light dash cancel to get speed. Nice ramp jump using the stairs and skip another little section. And you skip this path right here by just jumping straight down. And this is the last time we are switching to gravity. Normally you're supposed to do it a couple of times more, but fortunately they lined up the stage perfectly from here on out. So I could just do a butt boost right here and end up at the final section. The wall run. And I say switching gravity, but here's a little fun facts. Let's have some fun. Fun facts. Fun facts are fun, right? They don't actually switch anything. They just teleport you to different parts of the stage and change the music. Not at any point does gravity get switched. They are literally just teleports. Same thing in Mystic Mansion coming up. Rooms do not change. You are merely teleported around. It's all a ruse. Everything is a lie. So yeah, this stage was rather broken. Here is actually one of the least broken stages, yet it is incredibly fun, mostly because of the final section. And in this stage, I want level 3 Sonic to shield the robot. That's literally it. And Knuckles, I want a level 2 to get rid of some stuff. Level 3 Sonic first. That wall is not real. Exclusive to the GameCube version, that wall is just straight up not there. Doesn't even save that much, but it's nice. They just somehow forgot to put collision in that or something, I don't know. So yeah, these wonderful bobsleds also give level ups. There's the robot and using the shield. That's it for level 3 Sonic. You're done good, Sonic, you're done good. And this stage actually features a ability of the game that honestly hasn't been used yet, which might surprise some people, and that is the Team Blast. The Team Blast is a very powerful attack that insta-kills anything in an area. But the unfortunate part of it is that it also takes up, like, 12 seconds of animation for Team Sonic. There are various different lengths for the different teams. So it isn't useful in a lot of places, but here it is. And that's mostly because of the upcoming hammer robot that has armor. Oh my goodness. Who is now dead? There we go. So the way I actually did that is with a attack that not a lot of people know about because the game never tells you about it. Just straight up never tells you, and it's called the Lightspeed Attack. During the cooldown of the Team Blasts, Team Sonic has access to the Lightspeed Attack. And if you're in flight formation, if you're in speed formation and you jump and you press B, you will do the Lightspeed Attack, you will insta-kill basically anything around. However, that effect also applies to Sonic if he is used for a Thunder Shoot or Fire Dunk in the other formations. So in order to skip an animation for that, I used Tails to shoot our good friend Sonic. So yeah, combining getting rid of the four robots with getting rid of the hammer robot with the helmets, yeah, makes it worth. Oh my god! So hey, here's my favorite thing in this game, this entire section. First off, uncompleted light dash right there. Very cool jump. Can barely make that. Skip the pumpkins, because pumpkins are unreliable. You often with homing attacks on them. And we have Tails' section. Best left to Tails my ass. Tails is slow. We use in Sonic. That was incredibly risky, and if I died I'd lost a lot of time, but that's okay. Yeah. And there was once again a helmeted rammer robot, and you know they bad. They're just poorly designed. Even if I had no team blast meter whatsoever, I would still be better off building up a team blast with a glitch, and then doing the team blast animation, because finding them normally is incredibly slow. And hello FMS Addicts. This is actually a marathon channel, so the runners you will see playing games on here, myself included, this is not their actual channel. We are providing runs for this lovely marathon right here. Alright, Robot Wave boss fight. Level 2 Knuckles is basically all I need for the first, I don't know, 50 waves. And I got it, I got lucky. At some point I will need level 2 Flight as well, so I need to make sure I don't forget to pick up any level ups. Lord knows I've done that before. But for the most part, Knuckles and this team last is gonna carry us through. Here's the Lightspeed Attack in his actual animation. Takes a while, targeting is awful. Needless to say, if there's only one target, I don't want to use that. Why you gotta be so mean to me, the kid? Why you do this? Ba-ba-bam. In the meantime, Knuckles is still a powerhouse, and there's my level 2 Tails. Easy peasy. Just in time for this wave right here. Just gonna go off to the side, so that everything is nicely lined up.
What's the matter? Got nothing left?
I'm coming.
Just warming up.
This is only the beginning. Yeah. Shit, rock. Yeah. Shit, rock. Yeah.
Leave it to me.
Okay.
Here we go.
Oh, I see how it is.
That was great.
Blast away.
So yeah, there's that quote unquote boss fight.
Don't get too excited, boys. Those were the easy ones.
Alright, and with that we have arrived at the final zone, so two more stages and one more boss. And it's a pretty cool final zone. Casually, Final Fortress, the next stage, is not as good, but it just, you know, it's very... It's designed in a very slow way. It holds you up to do a bunch of nonsense often. It doesn't flow well. Speedrun it does though, so it's okay. First though, we have Eggfleet, and this would be up there as my favorite stage, were it not for the fact that it has auto-scrollers in it. Fortunately though, I can skip half the second one with a buff boost, but we'll get to that when we get to that. I've also been told these ships right here are supposed to have gates. I'm not sure what they're talking about. You have to, like, there's just a gate that stops you and you have to open the gate in order to progress, something like that. I don't know, I've never opened a gate in this stage in my life. There we go. Just go to the side of the ship right here. He's busy. And here's our auto swirlers. Don't tell me what to do, Knuckles. I am only complying because I want to live. So do you see this checkpoint right here? Yeah, that's the final checkpoint I'll get until I get to the bot boost, and it's also the most difficult bot boost in the run. So yeah. Remember that, when we get to it, I have not had a checkpoint in a long, long time. Oh yeah, pretty much Cooper Chris, so I'm doing movement tech all the time. The team system allows for so much depth that there's just stuff going on constantly. Oh boy. Didn't quite get enough height, so I did a tomato to make up for it. Nice little jump off of that rail. Trickier than it looks, but it's pretty nice. And now we have finally arrived at the bot boost, so that's like a good minute and a half I will lose if I fail this bot boost. And I failed the initial setup, so that will actually make it harder. Alright. That should be A-okay. Oh yeah. When submitted to SGDQ, the ad in the game was actually advertised as the Sonic Heroes of licensed cartoon games or something. I don't know what he said, but yeah, he made a reference to Sonic Heroes in his submission. It was pretty awesome. And yeah, the Edit and Eddie game is actually the only game that I can think of that implements it in a remotely similar way. But even then, it's not even close. Usually, whenever people introduce multiple characters, they just either give you the ability to switch between them at will, but you only control one at a time, or you get like, you control one and the others are completely AI controlled behind you, but maybe have one interactable feature or something, but here, like, pretty much everything involves the entire team. It just so happens that one of them has to be the leader every time. It's pretty unique. Say Wonderful 101 is something of its own altogether. It's like more like 10,000 people acting as one character.
This must be Eggman's headquarters.
The airbase.
How does this thing stay afloat? Doesn't matter.
See, that was a very nice egg fleet. Now we have Final Fortress. And like I said, there's a couple of places in this that actually flow really poorly, casually. I did not mean to do that tornado, that's slow. For instance, right there, they want you to destroy that incredibly bulky, slow robot and use a pole and everything, but simple jump takes care of that. Once again, killing the momentum with a pole here, but scenery has collision, so we A-OK. The biggest offenders are later in the stage, though. And there are also skips. First, we have this guy right here, who's in the way. And a nice combo makes quick work of him. Yep, there's a loop right here, unnecessarily big, so we're just gonna skip it. With the oh-so-dreaded rail switching. Another slowly designed section right here, so just jump to the rail and do a wall jump from here, easy peasy. But the biggest offender is right here, where you have to like go down there, activate three switches, go back up, and we skipped all of that with that glide and that jump. And you have to take like a really another pole and then a really high rail and everything. Blah. And then right here you have several fights with a whole bunch of very slow to kill robots. But Bob Boost makes quick work of that. And just go straight to the final rail section. And that's pretty much all that's left of Final Fortress. I will not murder Tails, for he has been far too useful this entire run.
standing by on time. I think you got, like, what, like 2 minutes?
Oh, less than that.
Less than that. Okay. Yeah, I'll be here.
If I do it correctly, then this upcoming boss fight will be 20 seconds long, so...
Oh, sick.
Yeah.
Yeah, just call it.
Will do. So the strategy I'm going to use here is I'm going to pick up 2 level ups for Tails, which will make his Thundershoot do damage. And it will also keep bouncing to different enemies. But because this guy will be moving backwards while he's doing his slashing animation, it will keep bouncing back onto him. And, well, you'll see how quick that makes work of him. If I do it right. I have a bad habit of messing this up. And time!
101.44.
Oh snap, that's good. Really happy with that.
Yeah, good stuff, dude.
It's pretty similar to what I got at the marathon I did a week ago. Almost the same, I think. And I also got a one cycle on that, so that's nice.
Awesome, dude.
Thank you.
Yeah, thanks for jumping on here, short notice.
No problem. And, glad I could help out.
Yeah, for sure. To all the folks at home, don't touch your dials. I am going to be right back.
Yeah.
With Mario Sunshine.
Indeed, and I will be back later this marathon with Sonic Colors.
Yeah, of course. More Sonic.
Yeah.
From Sid, so yeah, be sure to drop him a follow as well.
Thank you. All right, can I go?